Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from across the world. Our headlines: Palestinian Authority announces stricter COVID-19 restrictions, Germans honor victims of right-wing violence, Tunisians take to the streets protesting unemployment, police violence. We begin with an update on the COVID-19 situation. As of today afternoon, the number of cases had crossed 13 million with over 572,000 deaths. The WHO recorded over 230,000 cases on Sunday alone. In the meanwhile, the Palestinian Authority announced a stricter set of lockdown rules for the occupied West Bank on Sunday. The measure includes a complete ban on the movement of people between all the 9 governorates of the West Bank for 2 weeks. Other measures include a complete shutdown of the governorates of Hebron, Bethlehem, Ramallah and Nablus for 4 days. The PA has also imposed weekend curfews in all governorates starting Thursday night until Sunday morning for 2 weeks. Government spokesperson Ibrahim Melhem announced the formation of an operation room with Prime Minister Mohammad Shatai, the Health Minister and heads of security services to implement the lockdown. The order also asked the Palestinian citizens of Israel to desist from visiting their families and relatives in the West Bank during this period. It also restricts the movement of Palestinians working in Israel. Every day, thousands of Palestinians living in the occupied territories go to work in Israel while COVID-19 cases have surged following the country to announce a fresh lockdown on July 10th. On Sunday, occupied Palestinian territories recorded 349 cases, the biggest surge so far. The total number of infections so far stands at over 7,000 with 39 deaths, which are mostly concentrated in the West Bank. On Saturday, progressive sections in Frankfurt organized a gathering to commemorate the victims of right-wing violence in Germany. The meeting was organized on the second anniversary of the verdict on the notorious murders by the National Socialist Underground, or the NSU. The gathering was organized by the Frankfurt committees of various socialist organizations, anti-fascist groups and trade unions, including the Socialist German Workers' Youth and the Students' Wing of Die Linke. In the meeting, the participants denounced the rising hate crimes across Germany perpetrated by fascists and racist groups that predominantly target the minority communities and migrants. The NSU was a neo-Nazi terrorist group that perpetrated a series of racist violent incidents in Germany, including 10 murders between 2000 and 2007. All the victims were people with immigrant backgrounds from Turkish, Kurdish and Greek origins. There have been strong allegations of collusion by the police and intelligence department with the NSU in the violence. There are also allegations that the mainstream media underreported the involvement of neo-Nazi groups in the crimes. After widespread protests and international outcry, the NSU murder trial began in 2013 and concluded in 2018. The Munich Higher Regional Court eventually found 5 neo-Nazis guilty. The gathering on Saturday was organized by Frankfurt committees of various socialist organizations, anti-fascist groups and trade unions, including the Socialist German Workers' Youth and the Students' Wing of Die Linke. In the meeting, the participants denounced the rising hate crimes across Germany perpetrated by fascists and racist groups targeting the migrant communities and minorities. Recently, right-wing extremism, hate crimes and racist campaigns have been on the rise in Germany. Far-right political parties, including the Alternative for Germany or the AfD, have been expanding their base based on hyper-nationalistic and anti-immigrant campaigns. In our next story, we go to Tunisia, where protesters in the southern part of the country took to the streets on Saturday over rising unemployment and worsening living conditions. Hundreds participated in the demonstrations that were staged in the town of Ramada near the Libyan border. The town also held protests against the police killing of a young man last week, supposedly during an anti-smuggling operation. Protests in the south of the country have been raging over the past few weeks over the economic crisis in the region. The protesters are demanding that President Kais Saied address the situation in the south as well as the police killing. In Tatooine, about 80 kilometers from Ramada, protesters blocked access routes to the crucial El Kamour pumping station in the outskirts of the town. Last Thursday, President Saied briefly mentioned the situation but failed to list or talk about any current plans to deal with it. The Speaker of the Malaysian Parliament, Mohammad Arif Mohammad Yusuf, is said to be replaced by Azhar bin Azizan after he lost the contest for the post by a slender majority. The new Speaker is a nominee of the Prime Minister. In the vote that took place earlier today, the lower house of Parliament was divided roughly in the middle. 111 votes were in support of Azhar's candidacy and 108 voted for Mohammad Arif, and one abstention from a deputy speaker who conducted the election. Azhar's election is seen as a personal victory for the Prime Minister Muhyiddin Yassin, as it was the first test of a tenacious coalition that is currently supporting the government. Yassin came to power in March this year, taking over the government after a week-long political crisis precipitated by the abrupt resignation of his predecessor Mahathir Mohamad. The removal of the speaker, who was a Mahathir appointee, still does little to better the government's position, which hangs by a majority of just 3 votes in the House. In the meanwhile, Yasin's four-month-old government is already being criticized for its attack on the press and crackdown on asylum seekers. That's all we have in this episode of the International Daily Roundup. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch. Yeah, cantar, que vamos a triunfar, avanzar.